Meredith Klein, host of Tango Stories, which brings you glimpses into the lives of the dancers, musicians, organizers, and DJs who are part of the worldwide resurgence of Argentine tango. Thanks for joining me here on USALA Radio. If you're listening to this show on its original air date, which is Wednesday, March 6th, 2019, then really the sole purpose of this show is to get you to grab your car keys, hop into your car, and come join us for the Tango live music event, basically of the century here in Philadelphia. The band La Juan D'Arienzo, which was named Best Tango Orchestra in the World last year at the very first Premios Tango, which is the Tango Academy Awards, they are here in Philadelphia today, and they're about to start a whole evening of amazing events. It's the first time in history that an orquesta tipica, which means an orchestra, a tango orchestra that has the full complement of four bandoneons, is performing in Philadelphia. In fact, this orchestra, La Juan D'Arienzo, includes 10 musicians, four bandoneons, a double bass, four violins, and piano, and in addition to that, a wonderful singer, Fernando Rodas. This event includes activities for both dancers and non-dancers. So if you like tango music, you can have a great time at the event, even though you may not dance yet. It may make you want to dance, but you don't have to dance yet. The doors are going to open at 6 p.m. and all the activities start at 6:30 p.m. So where should you go in your car? You should go to the Lithuanian Music Hall in the Port Richmond neighborhood of Philadelphia. The address is 2715 East Allegheny Avenue, and that's right off. It's a stone's throw away from the Allegheny exit off of 95. So wherever you live, it's pretty easy to get to. The Lithuanian Music Hall was built in 1907 and 1908. It's a palatial, really gorgeous event space, initially for the Lithuanian community, and now which they generously share with all of us. And for this event, we'll be using their top floor, which is a 5,500 square foot, beautiful, extremely high ceilinged ballroom. It's a really special place. It's the place where we hold the Philly Tango Fest, so we've gotten to know it pretty well. There's also free secured parking tonight in a lot at 3380 Richmond Street, and you'd want to write down that address too, because it's three blocks away and it wouldn't be very obvious if you just pulled up to the hall. So tonight, what's going on? From 6:30 to 7:15 p.m., I'm going to be recording one of these Tango Stories interviews, and I'll be joined by the USALA program director, Fernando Mendez. So we'll be co-hosting this interview with some of the musicians of La Juan D'Arienzo, and that interview is open to the public. And then from 7:30 to 8:30, the whole band, La Juan D'Arienzo, is going to offer a workshop on tango music. And it's structured in a way that it's really informative and interesting and useful for people who dance and also for people who are just interested in tango music. So again, you don't have to dance to really enjoy this event. And then after that, from 8:30 p.m. to 1 a.m., there's a milonga, which is a tango social dance, with a concert by La Juan D'Arienzo, who will be playing two long 45-minute sets. And the live music portion is all contained between 9:30 p.m. and 11:30 p.m. So you can get to bed earlier if you need to, right? You don't have to stay till 1 a.m. So you can find all the details on all of this at philadelphiatangoschool.com. But before we go on and learn a little bit more about the band and a little bit more about the event, let's listen to the band. We're going to hear a recording of Paciencia, one of my favorite tangos, by La Juan D'Arienzo with singer Fernando Rodas. Paciencia.
Anoche de nuevo te vieron mis ojos, anoche de nuevo te tuve a mi lado, pa' que te habré visto si después de todo fuimos dos extraños mirando el pasado. Ni vos sos la misma ni yo, soy el mismo, los años, la vida, quién sabe qué fue. De una vez por todas mejor la franqueza, yo y vos no podemos volver al ayer. Paciencia. La vida es así. Quisimos juntarnos por puro egoísmo y el mismo egoísmo nos muestra distintos. ¿Para qué fingir paciencia? La vida es así, ninguno es culpable si es que hay una culpa. Por eso la mano que te di en silencio no tembló al dar. Habernos buscado y así buenamente nos queda el consuelo de seguir creyendo que no hemos cambiado. Yo tengo el retrato de aquellos 20 años cuando era del barrio el sol familiar. Quiero verte siempre linda como entonces. Lo que pasó anoche fue un sueño no más.
Once again, that was Paciencia of La Juan D'Arienzo with singer Fernando Rodas. And La Juan D'Arienzo with singer Fernando Rodas are in Philadelphia tonight, Wednesday, March 6th, for a big concert and milonga event. And if you missed the introduction, you can learn about it at philadelphiatangoschool.com. The band La Juan D'Arienzo is led by bandoneonist Facundo Lazzari, who provides a direct link to the Golden Age Tango Orchestra from which the band La Juan D'Arienzo derives its name. Starting in 1950, Facundo's grandfather, Carlos, was lead bandoneon player. Actually, he was the second bandoneonist, but he was the lead arranger and composer starting in 1950 for Juan D'Arienzo's orchestra. D'Arienzo's orchestra had already existed since 1935, but there were kind of regular changes of personnel as people came into the orchestra and then went off to do other projects. So around 1950, Carlos Lazzari became the chief arranger and composer for the orchestra, and he was in that role until 1976 when D'Arienzo passed away. And D'Arienzo had so much confidence in Carlos Lazzari that he even bequeathed him the rights to keep using the name D'Arienzo, which Lazzari did until he also passed away. So today, his grandson, Facundo, is here in Philadelphia, and he inherited the rights to the name Juan D'Arienzo, and just 7 years ago launched the band with that name, La Juan D'Arienzo, which has really taken the world by storm. La Juan D'Arienzo Orchestra recreates the rhythm, the energy, the playfulness of its namesake orchestra, and benefits from using many of the same musical arrangements which have been passed down to Facundo from his grandfather. Over the past 7 years, La Juan D'Arienzo has really exploded onto the worldwide tango scene. Since 2013, they've been touring extensively throughout Argentina, including playing at the very prestigious Buenos Aires Tango Festival. Since 2014, they've toured yearly in Europe, really massive tours that take them to many, many different cities and most of the major tango festivals in Europe. They've also completed two major tours in Asia. And what's relevant for us today is that the band is right now on about day 12 or so of their first US-Canada tour, which is taking them into 13 cities and playing 18 concerts between February 23rd and March 24th. Already, the response has been unbelievable. If you're on Facebook, you could follow La Juan D'Arienzo, and you can also follow a separate entity, their tour profile on Facebook, which is La Juan D'Arienzo in the US and Canada. And they've been doing a great job of documenting the tour with video posts, and it's just really inspiring and exciting to see huge crowds, many of them sold out, really going crazy over this orchestra all over the US. So, again, we're just over the moon excited that they're going to play here in Philadelphia tonight. And we'll keep talking about that. But for now, let's take a little musical break. We're going to listen to three pieces from La Juan D'Arienzo's second album, Siciliano, which came out in 2016. We're going to hear Re Fa Si, and then Corrientes y Esmeralda, which again features the voice of Fernando Rodas, and then Siciliano.
trapos junto a tu sochal, cuando un cajetilla los calzó de coros y te dieron lustre las patotas bravas allá por el año 902. Esquina porteña, vos hiciste escuela en una melancia de caña sin fin. Pasa Inglés y Monte, Bacará, Quiniela, Burdela de cañas y Locas de Piris. El Odeón se manda a la Real Academia, rebotando tangos al Royal Pigal. Y se juega el reto la doliente anemia, espera el tranvía para su arrabal. De Esmeralda al norte, al lado de Retiro, Montparnasse viene a caer la oración. En la francesita que con un suspiro nos vende el engrupe de su corazón. Esquina porteña, este milonguero te ofrece su afecto más hondo y cordial. Te promete el verso más rante y canero para hacer el tango que te haga inmortal. Te glosó en poemas Carlos de la Poa y Pascual Contursi fue tu amigo fiel. En tu esquina criolla cualquier cacatúa sueña con la pinta de Carlos Gardel.
Once again, you're listening to Tango Stories here on USALA Radio, and I'm your host, Meredith Klein. This whole show is about an event that's happening today in Philadelphia, a concert milonga by the incredible band La Juan D'Arienzo. I was so lucky to have the band's director and co-founder, Facundo Lazzari, join me by WhatsApp 2 weeks ago to give a really fascinating interview. So I want to listen to part of that now. So Facundo, was bandoneon the first instrument that you played?
Yes, it was.
When did you start playing? At what age?
I was 18 when I started to play, to study. Yeah.
Wow.
I was not so young.
And you hadn't studied another instrument?
No. Actually, I think before of that, I didn't think of being a musician or
So how did it
even an
happen?
artist.
How did you start play? How did it occur to you to start playing then?
It's a funny story because the thing it was I was about 14 or 15, and I really like to study. I mean, to read books and to study many
To
things. I
study
was in
anything.
high school. And I was always so curious about many things.
Yes.
So I like to study many different things. And the only thing I think I was doing that like artistic, it was writing poetry. So I had a book, like it was full of, I don't know, poetry from a 15 years old young guy. And I remember one day was Mother's Day, and I gave one of these poems to my mom. And she was so dramatic, as my mom is, like crying and so happy with my poem. And then she got my book and she read all the things that I was writing. And she said, "Oh, this is so nice. I really like. Maybe you can show this to your grandfather and you can do one tango with him. He can put some music."
Oh, that's
And I
so
said, "Oh,
sweet.
okay. Oh, yes, okay. I actually don't know. I haven't listened to tango in my life before, so I don't know if I can do this." And she said, "No, because this was the main thing. If you make some tangos with him, maybe you can get a medical insurance as an author of music, something like this." Yes, it was so crazy. Mom's ideas. And
That is so
okay,
funny.
I was so shy, so I didn't do it. But she took my book and she sent it to my grandfather.
Did he live in
I
a
didn't know.
different city or?
I'm sorry, I didn't.
Sorry, did you live nearby to your grandfather or did she send it somewhere far away?
No. He was living here,
Okay.
but I mean, she took my book and she brought it
Okay.
to my grandfather and she showed it to him. And so then my grandfather told me, "Okay, I've read your poetry. Okay." And it's really nice what you are writing, but this is not tango, because you are talking about many things that, okay, you have it in your mind right now, but this is not tango. So, but maybe if you start to listen tango, you can write something. I think you have the potential to write lyrics." And I say, "Okay, I will try, you know." I think he didn't like my things. It was so, I was so young. I don't remember what I was writing. But the
Yes.
thing was, I started to listen tango, and at this moment I was 17 years old.
Wow.
So I was about 1 year listening tango every night in my room, preparing all the exams I had to give for finishing high school. And I was always listening music. I was listening Bob Marley and Led Zeppelin and Juan D'Arienzo. And then, I don't know, Rolling Stones and Beatles and Juan D'Arienzo.
That's
So I
so
was
cool.
mixing everything with Juan D'Arienzo. It was the unique things I had at my house, to listen. At this point, it was not internet. So I had only records to listen. Everything was Juan D'Arienzo at my house. So Juan D'Arienzo every night, Juan D'Arienzo every night, listening and listening. And this year, I fell in love with bandoneon and with the sound of bandoneon. Like I was not able to understand how this instrument could do this, how someone could play this fast things and
Yes.
so clean, and it was amazing. I
Yes.
was amazed about this. So
Wow.
what I at this moment I went to my grandfather's house, and I was meeting him because I tried to write some lyrics with him, but I couldn't do nothing. And finally, one day I told to my grandmother that I was interested in playing bandoneon. But
Wow.
I was not brave to say to my grandfather I wanted to study, because he was so determinate with things. And I didn't want to say, I want to play bandoneon and then quit.
Yes.
It was not something that I was going to do.
Yes.
So I didn't ask to my grandfather. My grandmother asked to him. And then he said, hey, I heard you want to practice bandoneon. So let me know if you want, so I will get a bandoneon for you. I said, yes, I want to try. 2 years after, I was playing in the orchestra with him. I think it was 2 years.
Really?
I lost. Yes. I lost these 2 years in my room playing the bandoneon every day, whole day.
And your grandfather was still performing at that time?
Yes. He performed until the last day of his life, almost like this. Yeah.
And you got to play next to him?
Yes. I was playing 9 months with him. And one day he started to feel beat down, and he was so close to share these feelings, you know. He was so, I don't know how to say, how to explain it, like strong, you know. He started to feel not so good, and he couldn't go about 15 days, and then he died. It was so fast.
Very sudden. We
didn't have any time to. Yeah, it was really sad. It was really sad. But I had the pleasure to play next to him about, 10 months, something like this. In 2008, I started to play with his orchestra. The next year.
What were they called?
He died.
Was it still Los Solistas de D'Arienzo, or did they have a different name by then?
It was Orchestra Juan D'Arienzo.
Okay.
When Juan D'Arienzo died, he gave to my grandfather the rights of his name. And then his family gave the rights to him. So he used his name the whole life. With Los Solistas de D'Arienzo, that it was a quartet, only four musicians and a singer.
Okay, and they traveled extensively, right?
They traveled.
Did I read that D'Arienzo himself hadn't enjoyed traveling internationally, and so the band hadn't traveled as much when he was alive? But then
he was afraid. He was afraid to travel on a plane.
Yes.
So he didn't use planes in his life.
Uh-huh.
So he went to Uruguay, but not farther, I think.
Wow.
Because there are many, many beautiful stories about this. Because the orchestra traveled a lot, but he was not traveling. The conductor many times was my grandfather, and before was another one. The first time they went to Japan, it was in 1968.
So D'Arienzo was still alive, but he didn't go.
He didn't go.
Wow. So your grandfather traveled as the leader of the orchestra.
Yes, exactly. And there's a wonderful story that in this moment, when Juan D'Arienzo had to go to Japan, he said, I'm not going. The orchestra can go, but I'm not going. So the Hirohito Imperator, the Japanese Imperator, sent letters to him saying that he wanted to have him in Japan. And Juan D'Arienzo said, no, I'm not going because I'm afraid of planes. So the Imperator said to him, okay, don't worry, I sent you a ship, you know, a cruiser. He said, I'm not going to be 3 months on the sea, you know, and maybe these people get involved in a war or something. I am in the middle of the sea, I'm not going to do this. And they, okay, I sent you a submarine. And he said, I'm not going to be there, you know, to go in the submarine. I'm afraid of planes, you know. You can imagine what I think about submarines. So they say that the Imperator sent like a check, a blank check. How do you say? Like
yes, exactly, a blank
armor,
check.
You know?
Yes.
Yeah, And Juan D'Arienzo didn't go, you know. This is the story. Like, he was afraid. He said that after, in 1935, Carlos Gardel died on a plane crash.
Yes.
And after that, he said, okay, I'm not going to travel on a plane in my life. And he did it. So the orchestra was traveling without him all his career. Yeah.
Wow. So many things in there are amazing. But perhaps most amazing is that you started playing bandoneon at the absolute last moment. Like if you had waited another year or two, you wouldn't have had those 9 months with your grandfather, right?
Yes. Those are things that are things that you get by chance in life, you know, and there is not any explanation to this.
But what a remarkable thing.
I'm sorry, I couldn't.
No, just what a remarkable thing that you had that time to be able to play next to him.
Yes. I think if I had these feelings of playing bandoneon or listening to tango some years after, I would not be a musician or bandoneonist. I think I would be doing something else.
Yes.
It was such a coincidence in my life.
Yes.
I'm so grateful with the universe for that.
Really amazing. Let's take another break now and listen to a track from La Juan D'Arienzo, your band, Este es el Rey, which is a composition by your grandfather.
Yes.
It's hard to find another tango in existence that exudes quite as much energy as Este es el Rey.
I think, yes. It's a tango that it is, okay, it was played by Juan D'Arienzo Orchestra, but it is not the classic tango of Juan D'Arienzo style, and it is a bit dark and so serious and so elegant. There are not many tangos you can find in Juan D'Arienzo style that are similar to this. I really love this tango. People love this tango. Dancers love this tango. It's such a wonderful tango. Yeah.
Yes, and I absolutely love your recording of it. So here we go to listen to Este es el Rey of La Juan D'Arienzo. Thank you. now, we've been listening to music of La Juan D'Arienzo, and recently we just listened to the voice of the founder and director of that orchestra, Facundo Lazzari, from an interview that we did 2 weeks ago together. But now let's actually go way back in time and listen to three tangos from the original orchestra of Juan D'Arienzo, the original orchestra that played from the 1930s to 1970s. And we're going to listen to three tracks from the period of time when Facundo's grandfather, Carlos, was the chief arranger and composer and was playing the second bandoneon with that orchestra. So these are three recordings from 1963 of the Juan D'Arienzo Orchestra: El Irresistible, Pimienta, and then the very familiar Quejas de Bandoneon.
Thank you.
Once again, those were three recordings from 1963 of the Juan D'Arienzo Orchestra. And that brings us full circle to talking about tonight's event, where the modern day reincarnation of the Juan D'Arienzo Orchestra, which is called La Juan D'Arienzo, will be playing in Philadelphia. It's a huge deal. An orquesta tipica, which means an orchestra using the traditional instrumentation which was used to convey tango music during tango's golden age. It has never, ever before performed in Philadelphia. It's the first U.S. and Canada tour of this orchestra, La Juan D'Arienzo, which won Best Tango Orchestra in the World last year. It's just a huge thing. So if there's any way you can get here, you are invited to join. The events take place at the Lithuanian Music Hall, which is at 2715 East Allegheny Avenue. It's just off I-95 at the Allegheny Avenue exit. We've also secured a parking lot, which is free, which is three blocks away at 3380 Richmond Street in Philadelphia. The zip code is 19134. So you can park there. You can join us for a whole evening full of activities that are great for dancers and non-dancers alike. From 6:30 to 7:15, a Tango Stories interview with members of La Juan D'Arienzo, for which I'll be joined by USALA Program Director Fernando Mendez. After that, from 7:30 to 8:30, a tango music workshop that is taught by the band, and they've designed it to be super interesting and useful for people who do and don't dance tango. And then after that, a milonga, which means a social dance, at which the band is going to play live. That's from 8:30 p.m. to 1 a.m., and during the times when the band isn't playing, we have an excellent DJ from Italy who's traveling with the band, Mario Giattino. So please come out tonight. If you come for the interview only, it's just $15. If you take the workshop and the milonga, it's a separate $50. And if you only come for the milonga, it's $40. You can learn so much more about the events and about the band by going to our website, www.philadelphiatangoschool.com. If you want the whole URL, it's www.philadelphiatangoschool.com/la-juan-d'arienzo-in-philly. And from there, you can get to the band's website and to a press release, links to listen to their music, et cetera, et cetera. If you are listening to this this show after Wednesday, when you've missed all of this, I'm sorry. But we are bringing another orquesta tipica to Philadelphia that we're really excited about. It'll be during the Philly Tango Fest, which is Memorial Day weekend from May 24th to 27th. And it's going to be the debut of a newly created orquesta tipica directed by pianist Emiliano Messias. So that's Sunday, May 26th during the festival, the debut of this incredible orchestra that we believe is going to live for a very long time after that event. So if you did miss La Juan D'Arienzo, don't worry. And we do also really hope that La Juan D'Arienzo will come back next year. So to close the show, we're going to listen to three more tracks of the band La Juan D'Arienzo. The first is from their newest album. It's called the track is called Jamás Ni Nunca, and you can't even buy it on iTunes yet. The only way to buy the new album is to come out tonight to the concert and buy it on a flash drive. After we hear Jamás Ni Nunca, we're going to hear Quiero Verte Una Vez Más and Remembranza. And the last, actually all of those tracks feature singer Fernando Rodas. Thanks so much for listening to Tango Stories. Really hope to see you tonight at the big event with the band La Juan D'Arienzo.
Thank you.
lado aún te siento. Una lágrima enroscada en una flor. Aún retumban en mis pensamientos esos besos, esos pasos, ese adiós. Bien quisiera recordarte viendo cuántas veces me alegraste el corazón. Explícame, por favor, no entiendo que a mi amor lo despreciarás con traición. Jamás ni nunca no podré olvidarte. ¿Cuál es el sueño que no supe darte? Jamás ni nunca, sin tu amor no quiero vivir. Pero aún sufriendo esta herida que me cuesta la vida, yo te quiero feliz. Si supiera la impotencia que me invade, ¿dónde estás? ¿Con quién te fuiste? ¿Por qué te vas? Esa idea del control que se hace añicos y delata cuán lejos estoy de saber amar. Bien quisiera reencontrarte riendo, ver los huecos de tu rostro juvenil y en un abrazo con el corazón ardiendo saber que supiste elegir tu porvenir. Jamás ni nunca no podré olvidarte, tus tiernos besos, tu pasión, tu arte. Jamás ni nunca, sin tu amor no quiero vivir. Aceptaré tu partida aunque me cueste la vida. Yo te quiero feliz.
Quiero verte una vez más y en mi agonía. mío sentiré y olvidado en un rincón más tranquilo moriré. Un alivio sentiré y olvidado en un rincón más tranquilo. Son largas las semanas cuando no estás cerca de mí. No sé qué fuerza sobrehumana me da valor lejos de ti. Muerta la luz de mi esperanza, soy como un náufrago en el mar. Sé que me pierdo en la lontananza, mas no me puedo resignar. Qué triste recordar, después de tanto amar, esa dicha que pasó. Flor de una ilusión, nuestra pasión se marchitó.
Tuning into Tango Stories today. I'm your host, Meredith Klein. See you next week here on USALA Radio.